Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at another matrix determinant property by way of an example. Here's the matrix we're going to start the problem with. The matrix A is 1, 0, 1, 2, 5, 2, and negative 3, 5, 0. And the first thing we're going to do is just compute the determinant of the matrix A. So that's pretty easy. I'm actually going to go ahead and do expansion about the first row, do some cofactor expansion about that first row. So the determinant of A I can compute as 1 times the determinant of 5, 2, 5, 0 minus 0 times the determinant of this 2 by 2 matrix plus 1 times the determinant of the matrix 2, 5, and negative 3, 5. So this is just standard cofactor expansion about that first row. If you don't remember how to do kind of basic determinant computations, go back a few videos to check that out. But this is pretty straightforward once you know how to do it. And now we can continue our computation. The determinant of a 2 by 2 is very easy. You just multiply A times D minus B times C, the two cross terms. So it's going to be 1 times 5 times 0 minus 2 times 5, which is 10, minus 0 times this determinant, which we don't care about because it's going to be multiplied by 0, plus 1 times the determinant of this final 2 by 2. So that will be 2 times 5, which is 10, minus 5 times a negative 3, which would be a negative 15, so minus minus makes it plus 15. And then if we just simplify a little bit, we get negative 10 minus 0 plus 25, which all simplifies down to 15. So we have computed the determinant of the matrix A. All right, let's take a look at the next matrix we're going to work with. The matrix B is given by 1, 0, 1, 6, 5, 6, and negative 3, 5, 0. So you can see the first row is exactly the first row that we had for matrix A. The third row is the exact same values that we had in matrix A as well. So rows 1 and 3 of matrix B match rows 1 and 3 of matrix A. The only difference between matrix A and matrix B is the second row. And in fact, we can see that the second row in matrix B has essentially been multiplied by 3, right? The 2 became a 6, the 5 in matrix A became a 15, and the other 2 became a 6 as well. So let's go ahead and compute the determinant of B, and let's see how the value of the determinant of B has changed since the only thing we've done is change one row by a factor of 3. So again, let's just do normal cofactor expansion about the first row. So I'm going to have 1 times the determinant of this 2 by 2 minus 0 times this 2 by 2 plus 1 times the determinant of this 2 by 2 matrix. Again, just standard cofactor expansion about that first row. 1 times 15 times 0 is 0 minus 6 times 5 is 30 minus 0 times the determinant will always be 0 plus 1 times we'll get 6 times 5 is 30 minus 3, a negative 3 times 15, which is a negative 45, which is 45. Simplifying just a little bit, we get minus 30 plus 75, which gives us 45. So very straightforward determinant computation of a 3 by 3 matrix. We get the determinant of B is equal to 45. This is interesting. Notice when we computed the determinant of matrix A, we got 15. When we computed the determinant of matrix B, we got 45, which in fact we can write as 3 times the determinant of A. And this 3 is important because look at how matrix B differs from matrix A. Matrix B was the same as matrix A, except that one of the rows got multiplied by the number 3, and we ended up with a determinant that was equal to our original determinant, except being multiplied by the number 3. So this suggests something interesting. This is not a proof by any means. This is just kind of an example of the phenomenon. This is not a proof. But in general, if we have a matrix A and we know its determinant, if we create another matrix that's related to the first matrix, except a row has been changed by a factor, in other words, if we've replaced a row with k times the row, it's very easy to know how the determinant will change. The original determinant will be multiplied by whatever this factor is. So this is a general property of matrix determinants that we can always use. Now that we know it, we could have done this problem a lot simpler. If we knew that the determinant A was 15, and then we were asked to compute the determinant of this matrix, we really don't even need to go through this calculation over here. We can just use the property that since this row has been multiplied by 3, then this determinant will be multiplied by 3, resulting in 45. So that's a much simpler way to do determinant computations in the future. If you happen to know the original determinant, you can just scale the determinant by the appropriate value.